Resume Building Video 1 of How to Be a Professional Video Series. Brought to you by Santi. And by Rachel. Before you even start building a resume, the most important part is to brainstorm. Brainstorming involves writing down all the ideas about what you want a future employer to know about yourself. This list doesn't have to be perfect, but it should include all of the things that you've done, including any sports you've been in, skills, languages you speak, extracurricular activities, volunteer experiences, and especially any jobs you've had. This brainstorming list doesn't need to be complete or perfect, it's just a way to get your ideas on paper. After you've brainstormed, step two is formatting your resume. You want your resume to be neat and easy to read. It should include things like your name, your education, your work experiences, leadership skills, any awards you've received, community service, and any other special skills you want your employer to know. Your name, your address, your phone number, and email should be easy to read at the top of your resume. Start with your education. Include all of your education, including your high school and college. List the year you graduate and what high school you went to. Also include your GPA if it's above a 3.0. After your education, include any of your work experiences. Your most recent experience should come first. Include your title, where you worked, and from how and when you started, and from what until when. You should also include a brief description and any details of your job. These details can include any responsibilities or a brief summary of what you did. You should also include any leadership roles you've had, again, starting with the most recent. This could include things like being the captain of your sports team or a leader at your job. You should also include where you worked and the time that you did it. Be sure to include a brief description and any details you want your employer to know. After leadership, list any awards you've received. These awards can be from your sports, from your school, or any recognition you've received from your job. Again, be sure to include as much detail as you need to let a potential employer can understand what the award meant. After your awards, list any community service you have done. Again, begin with the most recent and give as much detail as your employer would need to know. For example, I volunteered to feed my starving children in Minnesota during 2004. Again, it's important to include a brief description. Next, add any skills. This could include any languages or any computer skills that you want your employer to know. Finally, the TORCH office is located at Northfield High School in room B101. We hope to see you soon. Thanks for watching, and good luck starting your resume.